Hi, I'm Mahesh. I'm the owner of Vinland. What we do here is we produce mushroom seeds. He's Mr. Bhushan from Bangalore. He's come here to visit our lab. He's interested in taking up a franchisee. So I'm just going to explain the process to him on board. So what we do to start with is mushroom is basically a kind of fungus. So we make grains, we boil the grains so that the fungus can eat the grains and stick to them. So the grains are just like a carrier from one place to another. Carrier of fungus from one place to another place. So what we do here is the grains are boiled. This is the grain boiler. This is the first process. So the grains are put in the boiler. It's entirely automatic. It's got a temperature controller there. There's a sensor there. So it just keeps boiling. There's a mesh there. When the water level goes down, by chance, if the water level goes down or if the valve is open, the heating fluid will go off by itself. Automatically it will go. Yes. Automatically it will go by itself. And you don't have to look at this. You look at the temperature here and then you know it's time to put the grains in. Then you bring it after the boil. You bring the grains outside, dry it for some time, and we use a specially formulated powder to coat the grains. And then we fill it into poly bags like this, these kind of poly bags. You put a ring and a cotton plug, and this process is completed. Now we come to the second stage of the process. Now the poly bags that I showed you there, these are all the poly bags that are ready. Now these poly bags go into this chamber. This is an autoclave. Yeah. And that's the sound of the steam generator that I'm going to explain to you. It's extracting the water by itself. Everything is automatic. So this, we put all these bags in this and we sterilize it for 3 hours. 3 hours. We sterilize it for 3 hours. Sanitize 3 hours. We sterilize it for 3 hours, and after that we take it to the inoculation chamber. And there we rest these bags for 24 hours before inoculating the mushroom fungus into these bags for it to grow. So these bags are ready. It's clean. It doesn't have any other bacteria. See, now we have boiled it, kept it outside. There's bacteria, viruses, and other fungi that's affected. So this sterilization process will kill all of them. Now what happens is when we boil and put it into these bags, after that only the customer will open it in the normal air. Until then we will not open it in normal air. We'll open it once in a clean room and that's it. That's in a clean chamber. So the outside air does not get in contact with these. So it stays as fresh as possible, it stays as clean as possible, and we require only one form of fungus. That's the mushroom fungus. And this is the steam generator. So this produces steam, gets into this chamber. There's a temperature monitor here, temperature and time. So this is the temperature and this is the time. So the time lapse, time is going, once it reaches zero, it automatically cuts off and no steam will pass through.
So this is automatically turned
on? Everything automatic. It automatically turns on, the timing starts automatically when the temperature reaches, and once it's off, the cycle will complete and it will not let any more steam pass through. Everything is automatic. And in this steam chamber, the water extraction is automatic, the generation is automatic, you can keep running this for a long time. In Indian technology, we have a round kind of a boiler which you have to pour the water all the time. So when you keep pouring water all the time, what happens is when the water is over, then the cycle is in between. Then you have to restart the cycle again. So this is our custom design. So that's the end of the second stage process. Now we go to the third stage process. I just want to go through in depth of the steam generator. What does the steam generator do? It only creates steam. It boils the water and it creates steam, just like a normal pressure cooker. create pressure cooker. It just creates a steam. Yeah? For that, we have three sensors on the top. We have contactors, we have water level sensors, we have the filament here. Inside, we have the filament. We give you, this is a 9 kilowatt, so we'll be giving you 12 kilowatt, a high capacity one. Why I'm giving you a high capacity one? Because when you start off with, there will be a lot of steam wastage when you start off with. And if you want to expand and you want to get another water table, so in the same steam generator can withstand two water plates. So your expansion becomes very easy and you don't have to buy all this equipment again all the time. You just have to buy one of the water plates again. Now what is happening? The water is boiled, the steam is passed, the water is over.
Okay.
The water is converted into steam. So this sound is what the water is being taken by this machine. So what happens, this steam generator is pulling the water in. Because the water level sensor is telling it, the water is over, I need more water. So it's pulling in. It's pulling in water now. And continuous generation of steam. So what happens is, in this continuous generation of steam, you can continuously run it. You don't have to look for water level. Sometimes the Indian way of doing it in this one, you have to pour the water in, then you have to wait for it to boil, then the water level goes down, the filament will get burnt out, the water level sensor is there, it will get off. But what is the use? You have to remove the whole steam, pour the water in, restart it again. By the time the water clean, the sterilization part, you have to restart again. So there's a time waste.
Technically
you can save time and it's much more safer. Much more safer, and there's a double safety feature in this. This one is the pressure gauge. So if this goes also, there's a pressure switch there, which will handle it. So if this goes, the pressure switch will handle it.
It's automatic.
It's automatic. And then you know, this you have to change this. Everything. If that goes, this one it will shoot up.
Is there any alert or anything if anything goes wrong?
It will just switch off. Yeah, it will just switch off. But if this is going more, then you just have to keep an eye on this. So we'll tell you. You just have to switch off one when the pressure goes up. And this is a high pressure, it's a 12 kilowatt. Okay? And it goes from 0 to 60 psi in 19 minutes. That's the specialty. Otherwise, any other boiler can take about 1.5 hours.
Okay, so this does within 19
minutes. 19 minutes, 0 to 60 psi. Ours is completely thermal control. Yeah? Okay, that's the end of this. We'll go to the next stage.
This one, what people do, they have a kerosene stove.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, outside. Put a honey, boil it.
Feel it. It's going slow. You will not even feel it. That's because of the machine.